It was in 1995, while studying in Berlin, Germany, that Timothy Ray Brown received grave news from his doctor. He was HIV positive. Years later, he received a second, potentially fatal diagnosis when doctors told him that he had the type of blood cancer known as acute myeloid leukemia. But Timothy's doctors offered him hope. In 2007 and 2008, Timothy received potentially life-saving hematopoietic stem cell transplants at the Charité Hospital. Little did anyone realize at the time that these two transplants would go on to become one of the discoveries of the century. At the root of the discovery was the fact that the stem cell donor had a homozygous deletion in the CCR5 gene. CCR5 is the co-receptor that HIV uses to enter certain immune cell hosts. The mutation of CCR5 found in Timothy's donor is not detrimental to cell function, but it prevents HIV from using CCR5 to enter the host cell. Because HIV can't enter these cells, the cells remain healthy and fight the infection. So when Timothy stopped taking his antiretroviral medication, on the day of his first transplant in 2007, he was not unprotected, as the new immune cells he received from the donor were HIV resistant and ready to fight. 3 months, only 3 months after the first stem cell transplant, HIV was no longer detected in his blood and his CD4 T cell count increased. Today, Timothy still remains off of antiretroviral therapy, but the story does not end there. Not only is Timothy considered to be the first person cured of HIV, but he also serves as a beacon of hope to the millions of people living today with HIV, showing them that one day there will be a cure for the horrific disease that they are living with.